Hello friends, in this video we are going to discuss about the construction and working of Vidicon camera tube, which are used in many of the industrial, medicine and education operation. Camera tube is basically considered as an eye of the TV system because it captures the image and converts it into the electrical form and then transmits it by using a transmitter. Different types of camera tubes are available in the market, and the major three types are image orthicon camera tube, Vidicon camera tube and plumbicon camera tube. These camera tube operates on a different principle of operation. Image orthicon camera tube operates on the principle of photo emission, whereas the Vidicon camera tube operates on the principle of photoconduction. Plumbicon is basically an extension, or we can say the upgrade version of the Vidicon camera tube. So it also works on the principle of photo conduction, but it has a different target. Now in this topic, we are going to discuss about the construction and working of Vidicon camera tube. So basically, the Vidicon camera tube functions on the principle of photoconductivity. In the case of photoconductivity, the resistance or the conductivity of the material is get changed when the light is incident on it. And specifically in case of Vidicon camera tube, depending upon which type of material we are using, so here the resistance of the target material get decreases when it is exposed to the light. That means the resistance of the photoconductivity get decreased when the light is incident on the photoconductive material in case of Vidicon camera tube. Now let's have a look of the construction or the cross section of Vidicon camera tube. So the figure shows cross section of the Vidicon camera tube, which consists of grids, then it consists of focusing coil, alignment coil along with horizontal and vertical deflection plate. Then it has a target connection which is having voltage of 30 to 60 volt, grid number 4 having voltage of 275 volt, whereas grid number 2 acts as an accelerator which having a voltage of 300 volt. Grid number 1 operates on the voltage range from 0 to 100 volt. Then it has a cathode. Grid number 3 is basically used for beam focusing purpose and having voltage range of 275 to 300 volt. So this is what about the construction of Vidicon camera tube. Now let's discuss Vidicon camera tube in detail. Now, whenever we require to connect the Vidicon camera tube in the circuit, then we require to perform such type of arrangement in which a load resistance of 50 kilo ohms is required to be connected before applying signal to the camera output, along with the capacitor, which is called as coupling capacitor, and it acts as a filter. So let's start with the explanation part. So in case of Vidicon camera tube, the target consists of thin photoconducting layer, which is either made up of selenium or antimony compounds. So this is deposited on the transparent conduction field and coated with the inner surface of the faceplate. This conductive coating is known as a plate, or we can say it is known as a single electrode. So now the image side of the photo layer, which is in contact with this single electrode, is connected to the DC supply through a load resistance RL. So if we move back to the circuit diagram, we will come to know the load resistance RL of 50K is used in between the power supply and the conducting plate. Now the beam that emerge from the electron gun, the electron guns are basically used to image the number of electrons, and the beam is get created that is focused onto the surface of the photoconducting layer. So by using two field, that is magnetic field and the electrostatic field, the electron beam is get combined. So here it is mentioned that by combining the action of uniform magnetic field and electrostatic field, the magnetic field is created by the external coil, whereas the electrostatic field is get created by grid number 3. So from the construction diagram, we come to know that the grid number 4 is also present over there, and it provides a uniform field between itself and photoconducting layer so that the electron's beam approaches the layer having very less velocity, and that prevents any secondary emission. Now deflection of the beam is controlled by the horizontal and vertical deflection plate. The alignment plates are used for making alignment of the focused electron beams. Now let's see how the charge image it gets produced in case of Vidicon camera tube. Now the photo layer which is used in the Vidicon camera tube having a thickness of 0.0001 cm, and it provides a resistance of up to 20 mega ohms when it is placed in the dark region. Now when the light is focused onto the photoconducting surface, or when the light is focused, or white light is focused onto the photo layer, then the resistance of the photo layer is get reduced near about 2 mega ohms, and that is because the electrons are get transferred from valence band to the conduction band, because of which the resistivity of the material gets decreasing, and that decrease in the resistivity is still the value of 2 mega ohms. So higher value of resistivity provided by the photo layer is of 20 mega ohms, and the lower value when white light incidence on it is nothing but 2 mega ohms. So when the bright light falls into the area of photoconductive coating, the resistance becomes as less as 2 mega ohms. Thus, the image on the target at each point on the gun sight of the photo layer assume a certain potential with respect to the DC supply depending upon the resistance of the single plate. So depending upon the intensity of the light energy, the resistance of the photoconducting material or the resistance of the photo layer is get changed. So because of this, a pattern of positive element is get created on the gun side of the photo layer, and that results into the formation of charge air in case of Vidicon camera tube. Now let's discuss the next point, and that is related to storage action. As we know, in case of Vidicon camera tube, the light from scene falls continuously onto the target, and each element of the photo coating is scanned at equal interval, which results into the storage, and that equal interval is nothing but the equal to the frame time. So that results into the storage action and net change in the resistance. So when the intensity of the light is get changed, a positive pattern is get created onto the face of the photo layer, and that results into the reduction in the value of resistance. The storage time for all the points on the target plate is same. The net change in the resistance of all the element areas is proportional to the light intensity variation of the scene, which is televisioned. So depending upon the value of intensity, the resistivity of the material is get changes. It basically get decrease when the light energy or the light intensity is higher, and the resistance get increased when light intensity is lower value. Now next one is nothing but the signal current. So the sudden change on the potential of each element results into the current variation across the load resistance RL. So amplitude of the current and the consequent voltage across RL is directly proportional to the light intensity. Because depending upon the light intensity, the resistances get changes, which affects the value of current. And because of that, the voltage produced across the load resistance RL is also get vary. So depending upon the light intensity, the value of the voltage across RL and amplitude of the current is get changes. So large current causes higher voltage drop across RL. The output voltage most of the cases are negative in white areas. Now the next concept is nothing but the leaky capacitor concept, which is also related to the formation of charge image, or we can say it is considered as a second method for producing the charge image. So let's understand the concept of leaky capacitor. So the development of the charge image on the photo layer is to be considered as an array of individual capacitor or array of individual target element. Each element consists of capacitor connected parallelly with the light dependent resistance. The number of such representation, let's see the diagram so that we can get the idea of leaky capacitor concept. So here one end of the target is connected to the electrode, another end is unterminated to the scanning beam or electron gun. Here also it is mentioned that the number of such representation as we have just shown in the figure. So one end is connected to the signal electrode, another end is unterminated facing the beam. So in the absence of any light image, the capacitor attained a maximum voltage that is almost equals to 40 volt, and that is because of the time. When the image is focused on the target, the resistance in the parallel with the capacitor changes its value depending upon the intensity of the light falls onto the resistor. As the resistors are light dependent resistance, therefore because of which the capacitor gets charged depending upon the intensity of the light. For high light element, the resistance across the capacitor get decreases, because if the more white light falls onto the resistance, the photoconducting material having property to reduce the value of resistance. So for high light, the resistance across the capacitor decreases to a low value that is approximately equals to 2 mega ohms and permits lots of charge from capacitor to leak away, and that results into the formation of leaky capacitor. When the black areas of the picture incidence, the resistance goes on increases, and therefore there is no leakage of charges. So when more white light falls onto the resistors, then the value of leaky current get increased, and when more dark light falls onto the resistor, the value of leakage is get reduced. So the resultant small current that flows develops a lower voltage across the load resistance. The electron beam sees a charge onto the each capacitor and while scanning the target and delivers more or less number of electrons to the recharge them to the supply voltage. So this process repeats after every 40 milliseconds in order to provide the necessary video signal corresponds to the picture detail at the upper end of the load resistance. So the video signal is fed through the blocking capacitor to an amplifier for the necessary amplification. So this is what about the working of Vidicon camera tube. In case of Vidicon camera tube, the construction wise the tube is simple in construction as compared to the image orthicon tube. Also the cost is less. Also its cost is less as compared to image orthicon tube. It provides higher resolution and simple construction. So these are basically considered as an advantage of the Vidicon camera tube. But it has a disadvantage of non-linear characteristics. But due to the simple construction and less cost, it is used in most of the application which include industrial application, education field application, medical field application and many more. Or most of the television system uses the same camera tube, that is Vidicon camera tube, because of the construction wise simplicity and cost wise factor. So this is what about the construction of Vidicon camera tube, which uses a material or which uses a principle of photoconduction in which the resistance is decreases when white light falls onto the surface of the photoconducting material. So I hope you understand the topic of construction and working of Vidicon video tube or Vidicon camera tube. So thank you very much for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ekeeda. Subscribe Ekeeda. Thank you.